Hello everyone. In the previous class, we have studied the different terms related to our geotechnical engineering like void ratio, porosity, degree of saturation, then water content, percentage air voids, air content, and all these terms we have studied. And at last, we have studied what is density and what is unit weight and what is the difference between density and unit weight. So now in this class we study the different terms related to our density and unit weight. Both I will write simultaneously. Here the density I am writing, and this side I am writing unit weight, so that there will not be any confusion within you the difference between density and unit weight. Again, I am repeating, density means what? We are denoting as rho, that is equal to mass by volume. Okay. What is unit weight? It is denoted by gamma, and that is equal to weight by volume. Difference between weight and mass is weight equal to mass into gravity. Clear? Okay. Now we'll see different types of density and unit weight. Suppose first one I am writing here bulk density. Bulk density. Okay. In bracket writing gamma bulk. That is equal to, it is density, so rho. Here unit weight same, we are starting bulk unit weight. In bracket I am writing gamma bulk. Okay. Now what is the difference? Bulk density means what? I already told, mass by volume. What is bulk density? Bulk density means the total moisture mass, means whatever the mass available, that is divided by total volume will give you the bulk density. Means gamma mass total by volume. V means total volume. Here also same, weight total by volume, moisture and all these things will include here. Okay, you can tell bulk or gross also is telling. Next term is, if I write dry density. So here it will be gamma dry. So now the question is, what will be gamma dry? Mass of the dry soil to the total volume, yes or no? So mass of the dry soil by volume. Okay, this will be your dry density. The same case, dry unit weight, that is gamma dry. So what will be gamma dry? Weight of dry soil by volume. Same thing, just the weight will be changed. Here the total weight we are taking bulk. Dry means only dry weight, dry soil. Okay, yeah, you can tell mass of solid. Okay, here because after drying the mass of our air and water will not be there. So only the mass of solid part will be here. Okay, you can tell mass of solid also by total volume, weight of solid mass by total volume. Next one is, if I tell saturated density, I can write rho sat saturated. okay, same thing like this. Okay, if the soil mass is totally saturated, then bulk density is only called your saturated density. Okay, if the soil mass is completely saturated, means air will not be there, then saturated density is same as our bulk density. There is no difference. Third one, here also same thing, saturated unit weight, no difference from bulk unit weight if only water is present, means only saturated mass, that is gamma saturated. Okay, if I will tell last one, submerged density, submerged density, rho submerged, means the same thing, mass of that submerged body by total volume, same thing. This formula will rarely use, but after this I will write some important formula that will be used most of the cases. This is just for your fundamental understanding. Submerged density is also called your buoyant density. Okay, the buoyant force is there, so that is why it is also called buoyant density. Here the submerged unit weight, you can write gamma submerged. Here also weight of the submerged mass by volume. These are the fundamental formula and fundamental thing to understand different types of density and different type of unit weight. Okay, so now I will relate this term with our void ratio, porosity, specific gravity, all these things whatever we studied in the previous classes. So now let's start this one. Okay, so now I will write some important formula that will be useful for solving problems. Okay, this formula you have to remember. Okay, so rho bulk can be calculated by using a formula Z plus ES into density of water by 1 plus E. Okay, what is G here? Specific gravity already told, still I want to write for your understanding. If you are not able to remembering this thing, let's write here only. G means specific gravity. Here I am writing already, you know this term, still I am writing this one for a revision purpose. E means void ratio, that also you know. Okay, next S means degree of saturation, this also you know. Rho W means density of water. Okay, what is the value of rho W? Rho W value is 1000 kg per meter cube. Remember this. Okay, here also same thing I will write. Just difference will be rho W will be replaced by our gamma W. Okay, that is unit weight of water. So, just write same formula G plus CS into only replaced by gamma W. Then rest of the formula will be same. What is the value of gamma W? That is 9.81 kilonewton per meter cube. Okay, gamma W means unit weight of water. Clear? Next, we will move to gamma dry. okay, how to, only I am giving some hint, no need to remember rest of the formula. If you remember this bulk unit weight or bulk density, then rest of the formula you can easily derive. Like, how to calculate dry density now? Dry means what? Saturation is zero. I already told in the previous class. In dry soil, the degree of saturation S value is zero. So for the dry soil, I'll put S equal to zero here. Okay, then rest will be same. Put S equal to zero, then this formula will be G rho W by 1 plus E. Clear? Next, same thing you are right. Put S equal to 0. Then write the same formula, G gamma W by 1 plus E. Clear? Next, third formula, saturated density. Hope this you already written. So what is saturated density? So rho saturated will be, for saturation S value is how much? S value is 1, yes or no? For dry soil S is 0, and for saturated density S equal to 1, saturation is 1. Put S equal to 1, then it will be G plus E into gamma W by 1 plus E. You can write rho W because it is density. So, by 1 plus E. Clear? Just put S equal to 1. Here I am writing S equal to 1. So, here like this. Now, saturated unit weight, same thing. Just replace by gamma W. Gamma saturated equal to G plus E, put S equal to 1. By gamma W by 1 plus E over. Okay, here S equal to 1. Okay, clear? Note it down, all this formula. Here 1, 2, 3, this 4, 5, 6. I recommend to remember only this formula. Okay, next you can derive. If you remember this one, just replace S equal to 0 for dry soil, replace S equal to 1 for saturated soil. Here also same thing, density case mein rho W put karo, unit weight case mein gamma W put karo. Gamma W ka value hai 9.81 kilometer per meter cube, rho W value is 1000 kg per meter cube. Remember all these values. Clear? Now last one, submerged density, the space is not there. So next, I will write it here. Fourth one is submerged density. That is rho submerged. Here the fourth one is submerged unit weight. So now, what will be the formula of rho submerged? Rho submerged means our same formula I will derive from bulk density. What is the formula of bulk density? G plus ES into rho W by 1 plus E. Okay. So submerged density can be found out by taking the difference between bulk density to density of water. It will be your submerged density. Here also same formula I can write. Bulk unit weight minus unit weight of water. This will be your submerged unit weight. Okay. So now I can derive this formula, rho bulk minus rho w. Just put it here, you can find out the value. Because rho bulk already you know, this one, and rho w already you know. If you take the difference, then you will get the answer. Here also, same thing. What will be gamma bulk? Gamma bulk will be g plus es into gamma w by 1 plus c. Gamma subsurface means this minus gamma w. That will be your submerged unit weight. Hope this is clear. All about your density unit weight and different type of density and unit weight. Next term is your density index. That is ID. Okay. So what do you mean by density index? Density index means, this term is generally used for finding out the relative compactness for a soil mass. Okay. So this term is generally used for our cohesionless soil. Cohesionless soil के लिए term use होता है density index, or it is called relative density. It is also called as relative density. Okay, this is generally used for cohesionless soil. So what are the examples of cohesionless soil? I already told in the previous class, that is example is our most common example is our sand and gravel. Here the most commonly example. And what is the opposite of cohesionless soil? That is cohesive soil. The example is our silt, clay, all these soils are cohesive soil. But the relative density term is only used for cohesionless soil. That is sand and gravel, we can use the term relative density or density index. So how to find out this density index? This term generally gives the percentage the percentage of voids there in a soil mass. Okay, so this can be find out by the void term is coming, so I am using the void ratio term. Void ratio notation is our E. So this can be find out by using the formula E max minus E natural by E max minus E min into 100. This can give you the density index. Now the question is, what is E max? What is E min? And what is E natural? Okay, E max means what? Maximum void ratio. Or you can tell the void ratio in a loose soil. I can write in bracket void ratio in loosest state. Because when the soil is loose, the void ratio will be definitely more. More voids will be present. So the we are getting maximum void ratio. Minimum is just opposite. Minimum void ratio, that is void ratio in densest state. Densest state means the soil is in very dense, means void ratio is very less. Soil is compacted to a denser medium, so we can get the lesser void ratio in this state. Next, last one is natural void ratio. Natural void ratio means which is present in the soil mass. Naturally, which is present in the soil mass. Suppose we are taking a soil mass, so what is the present void ratio in that soil mass? That is the natural void ratio. In that case, we are not taking the loosest or densest state. We are just calculating the natural word ratio. So after calculating these three terms, then you can find out the density index or relative density for a soil mass. Again, I am repeating, this term is generally used to find out the relative compactness or looseness in the loosest state or densest state for a soil mass, and this is only used for cohesionless soil. This cannot be used for cohesive soil. Now the question is, after finding out some value of relative density, how to know that is loose soil or how that is dense soil or that is medium soil? For that, one table is given. Okay, the table is given, the range is given of the value. If the value lies in this state, then that is loose soil. If value lies in another range, that will be your dense state. So last part of this lecture, the range of different density index value for different soil. Note it down. Density index value here. Here you can write type of soil. Okay. If the density index value is 0 to 15, then that will be called very loose soil. If the density index value is 15 to 35, then that will be called loose soil. If the value is between 35 to 65, then that soil is called medium soil. If the value is from 65 to 85, then that is called dense soil. If the value is between 85 to 100, then that will be called very dense soil. Okay, these are the ranges. After finding out the value, suppose the soil we are getting relative density, suppose 30%. So the value, the soil, it can be called loose soil. If we are getting the value, suppose 88%. So the soil is very dense soil. Like this, you can classify the soil mass if that is cohesionless soil. Remember this, the soil should be cohesionless. Okay, this is all about this lecture. If any doubt, you can contact me. Next class will study the different relationship between different terms we have studied till now. Next, after studying the relationships, we can solve number of problems. Then this chapter will be over. Hope this class you have understood all these things. If any doubt, call me. Thank you.